I'm Brendan Buckley, and I'm here today in Los Angeles in the House of Rock. At some point, I figured that was about as far as I can go, teaching myself, watching MTV and teaching myself how to play things. So I asked my high school band director to recommend a drum teacher, and he happened to be very good friends with a guy named Tommy Igo. I lived in New Jersey at the time, so I would go to New York to go see his gigs too. So I had a teacher who was showing me not only how to play the drums, how to read, how to play big band music, but also what it was like to work as a freelance musician. I think a lot of drummers, they take lessons, and at some point they're like, okay, now how do I become a famous drummer? And they don't really see that little by little, step by step process of doing that. Could feel the sun about to rise when I realize we had nothing to fear. Just me, my daddy, and a kid named Cope, but making music that nobody would hear.
It seems that you are, if you're not on tour, you're definitely doing something in town, you're playing with the band. Tell me a little bit about that for you.
Well, I guess it's what I've always done. It's I love recording, but I also love playing live shows. I love touring and playing with friends' bands and subbing for friends and on various tours if they can't do it. It's that juggling act that I've always liked about having a career in music. You watch me bleed until I can breathe. I'm shaking, falling onto my knees. And now that I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing stitches, tripping over myself. I'm making, begging you to come help. And now that I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing stitches. When I turned 18, I moved to Miami to study at the University of Miami, their conservatory there. Day one, blown out of the water. Like, I was the worst guy in the school. I'm like, how do these guys know how to play like this? This is crazy. But it's not disheartening to me. It's inspirational. It shows you how much further you need to go. So I started a whole new regiment of woodshedding, it was great for me. I met all these great music buddies, Venezuela, Cuba, Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico, Costa Rica, Colombia. Nothing but warm welcomes. Like, if you could keep a beat, they could use you in their group. It's okay, just play this and you'll learn over time, So I was playing in a lot of bands, just being the dude in the back, just trying to keep time and figuring out where beat one was. And once I figured it out and figured out the name of this beat, and I would add that to my vocabulary. It's so different to do that than to just learn a samba pattern or a songo or mambo pattern out of a book. If you're in a band, you're like, I know what's working and what's not working. Usually, when I hear good mottos or good quotes, I write them down, but I can't think of too many. But one that I like a lot is, don't practice things until you get it right. Practice things until you cannot get them wrong. I like that one.